In this example, it is given that a neutron moving at a speed v undergoes a head-on elastic collision with a nucleus of mass number A at rest. We are required to find the ratio of kinetic energies of neutron after and before collision. Now, let's again first analyze the situation. We are having a neutron. Let us consider it is having a mass m. It is moving at a speed v. It undergoes a head-on elastic collision with a nucleus, which is of mass number A. If its mass number is A, we can consider its approximate mass to be MA. When it collides, after collision, we can state, when the neutron collides with the nucleus, which was initially at rest, after collision, say, neutron moves at a speed v1 and say nucleus moves at a speed v2. So, here we are not interested in the speed of nucleus as we are required to find the ratio of kinetic energies of neutron before and after collision. Now, in this situation, if neutron speed is v1, we can directly use the expressions for speed of a particle after head-on elastic collision. We can say after head-on elastic collision, speed of neutron is, this can be given by the expression v1 is equals to m1 minus m2 upon m1 plus m2 into u1 plus 2m2 upon m1 plus m2 into u2, where u1 and u2 are the speed of first and second particle before collision. Here we can see as nucleus was at rest, so its u2 can be taken as 0 and u1 can be taken as v. We just substitute with the parameters, we'll get v1 is equals to m1, we can write as m minus m2 can be written as ma upon m plus ma multiplied by v. This expression gets cancelled out as u2 is 0. So, this will be 1 minus a upon 1 plus a into v. If we just calculate the ratio of kinetic energy after and kinetic energy before collision, say it is Kf and Ki. Kf is the final kinetic energy of neutron, Ki is the initial energy of neutron. If we just substitute the values, the final energy will be half mv1 square divided by it is half mv square. Here half and m gets cancelled out, it is v1 square by v square, which can be written as 1 minus a upon 1 plus a whole square. That will be the answer to our problem.